Hello everybody, my name is Todd Barber, chairman of the Reef Ball Foundation, and I'm here to give you a brief tutorial on how to use the Phantom 2 quadcopter outfitted with a GoPro 3 camera to help enhance survey work for the Reef Ball Foundation. Mostly we'll be surveying things like submerged breakwaters, mangroves, shallow reef corals, and clear water. This will eliminate the need for some of our volunteers to have to go up in helicopters and planes, which can sometimes be dangerous and expensive in the countries we work in. All right, so we're going to start off with, this is the Phantom 2. It's called the Vision. It has its own built-in camera. This camera is primarily used for navigation through your cell phone. It's able to see in front of it. The first-person view is if you're flying the helicopter. It also records high-definition video, which can be useful for capturing events like casting of reef balls and other types of things where people are involved. But this camera is not accurate enough for the type of survey work that we might want to do in creating survey maps. So I've mounted a second GoPro Hero 3. It will just barely fit with a GoPro mount in this position, lower quadrant. This is a standard GoPro mount with it in the upside down mode. You have to set the field of vision to medium. If you don't, you're going to catch the props on this. And you want the camera to be facing directly down. Now this camera is not going to be on a jello mount, which is basically a mount which keeps this camera very stable and steady. It's going to be directly onto it. All you're going to be doing is flying very slowly and having it accurately going straight down. That makes there's less distortion in your survey work. This camera here, you'll see a curvature of the Earth, whereas this will be face down and be able to accurately overlay on Google Earth where we do our maps and our GIS systems. Okay, you want to make sure and keep your batteries cool before takeoff. I've added a guard system. I've painted one side of it bright orange, the back side bright yellow. This is it tells me orientation of which way the helicopter is flying. It's very important to just be able to see it from a distance and make sure you got your cameras pointing in the right direction. The string also gives you additional protection, and that way if you did bump into any kind of an object, it is much safer, including accidental contact with volunteers. Now, I do put my GoPro case into a watertight container. It does have sound on it, but it's going to be really just capturing the sound of this. The only reason I'm putting it watertight is because at the foundation we're going to be flying over water. These are not waterproof. That's why it takes lots of training and skill and practice. I am a certified pilot and have spent a lot of hours working on this system, and I encourage you guys to fly safely over an unpopulated field for many, many, many flights until you really get control of your system. Also make sure everybody's cell phones are turned off and internet connections are turned off, particularly any internet connections that your phone will automatically hook up to. Those can cause interference during flight. The flight procedure, you want to pick a day like today. This is a fairly light winds, although this is probably up to 8 miles an hour. I don't like to fly over water in anything over 10 miles an hour. It is certainly capable of flying up to 32 miles an hour, but you certainly don't want to have all the extra weight of the cameras on those things. Alright, I always face the camera. So they'll tell you in the instruction manuals to face it the front towards you or away from you. I don't do that because I've got the GoPro camera mounted on the back, so when she first takes off she's a little bit out of weight and balance and she'll tend to come this direction, so I put it this way. The fire up procedure is you turn on your Wi-Fi connector. That's for enhancing your cell phone's Wi-Fi connector so I can talk to the camera and get a signal back. You fire up the Phantom 2 by pressing it once and then pressing a second time and holding it down. You'll hear it turn on. It's very important you set it in one location and you allow it to sit there long enough for it to pick up a GPS signal. You never fly until you have at least 6 satellites, and over water I like to have 7, 8, or 9. If it runs out of GPS signal, it will have to fly manually, and that's a very high probability of crashing, and again, you don't want to lose a $1,200 Phantom. You want to check and make sure that your camera is turned on. I've got Wi-Fi on the lower camera, and I'm going to turn my GoPro on. Again, it is now working. Now I will configure my cell phone, making sure that that I am in the airplane mode. You don't want any signals coming in. You don't want any phone calls coming in when you happen to be flying. That my Wi-Fi is turned on. And I will give it time to pick up the Phantom, and it will say Phantom. A little bit of sunshine here, so I'm going to put a block on it so I can see it a little bit better. It's just a piece of foam that I've cut, and I found is a convenient way to block the light out so you can see your camera very well. And we will wait the time required for it to get a connection. Okay, it is looking for the network. And it just found the Phantom. Now I will turn on the software. This is the vision software that comes with the camera. Go into camera mode. And I can confirm that I can see a camera. Now I'm going to set this forward camera. You can see, watch it turn. And as you see, I've got it facing forward. By having it facing forward, I'll get less of a, I'll be getting a pan shot, and I'll be recording that while we go, so I'll go ahead and start that camera as well. I can start it or take pictures. That's just an auxiliary camera for us to record the event. Alright, now I have got enough satellites to fly. My vision is... Something seems to have happened. Let's see what's going on with the vision. There it goes, it is now working. Probably got a flash of the bright sunlight on it. Okay, now we are going to move all objects more than 2 meters away and start the engines. Okay, when you fly, I'm going to take straight up. Hold it steady for just a bit. That gives me time to see if the GPS is working properly. Wait till it stabilizes. It's not. If it's not holding position, you do not want to fly over water. But no, it is still getting drift, and I do not like that, so I'm going to come back in and land it. Possibly there's a interference. And this will be a no-fly. And you see it is actually on, not on green light. When you do a manual landing, it's not nearly as good. Now, for some reason, I see the problem. Looks to me like our Wi-Fi setting was still left on the GoPro. Turning everything off, and I'm going to reset it. I'm going to stop this camera now, and we'll come back for segment 2.